Security was tight at the Monarch Gala. You took quite a risk walking into the lion's den.
If we were gonna kidnap Dr. Amaral, then we needed to do it from the inside.
Beth Wilder. You were quick to trust her.
We had common interests.
Is that all you had?
It's all we needed.
Well, I was starting to think seeing a pretty lady like you is too much to hope for.
Why don't you keep your mouth shut while we get some privacy before we begin? Okay.
How about you get me out of this chair?
Stop squirming. And you're gonna need this.
I appreciate it.
Sure.
What's it look like out there?
I think you're secure. Everyone's concentrating on the party. So far, your crazy plan's working.
And Dr. Emerald?
I don't have a fix on her. She's either at the party or at her office at the R&D facility here on the island. I'll scout out the party.
So you're gonna sip champagne while I break into a high-security installation. Looks like you got this all figured out.
I'll save you a cocktail, weenie.
Oh, well, in that case...
My cover isn't gonna survive the night, but it'll last a little longer, so you can't walk out the front door with me. This is the quickest way to the R&D facility. I disabled the security at the back door, but there'll be guards. Contact me when you're clear. And Jack, you know what's at stake here. This can't be about revenge.
I'm not here for Paul.
He's escaping!
In the morning.
My powers were growing. I was learning to control them better. That felt good.
Who the hell designs these doors? Okay, I'm gonna have to move faster to get through. Very sci-fi and very monarch. Something tells me it wasn't commissioned by them, though. Hey, Beth, I'm clear. What's next?
You'll see a radar tower up ahead soon. Let me know when you get inside.
Warn me about that one, Beth. Okay, how am I getting to that radar tower? I need to get across somehow. Must be a way across. Armored.
you go.
Spin it however we want. Call it an accident. Or pin it on Joyce.
Yeah, he might as well take the blame for the mess he made.
What the?
That's all of them.
Time felt broken here. The whole canon felt unstuck in time. The timeline of the old cannon felt loose. I could shift it around.
Smart place to aim the cannon, guys. All right. Okay, quicker next time.
Say these stutters are getting more frequent. If one hits while we're grabbing Dr. Amaral...
You'll be frozen. Yeah, I know. It's a risk.
Monarch specialist troopers have the stutterproof gear. I bet Dr. Amaral would have that in her office, too.
I'll keep an eye out. See if I can grab her soon. Thanks, Beth. Need to get to the radar tower. Okay. Next stop, the radar tower. God. Beth? I'm at the radar tower. Where's the lab?
Below your feet. It's all top secret. The elevator inside will take you down.
Hello, Riverport.
Oh, seriously? What is this, a Bond villain?
You have no idea. Just don't fall into the shark tank.
On the in crowd, you know where the... You're not gonna be the only ones.
Fuck. Alright, that's it. Speech is streaming. Let's give Monarch the audience
they deserve. Unfortunately, Mr. Serene is preoccupied with as many duties necessary to assure we maintain control over our path forward. And that's what tonight is about. The future. We all knew this day was coming, even if many of you out there aren't sure what it means. We're entering a new phase in our operation. One that presents new risks and new demands. One that requires... The Cronon Field Regulator, or CFR. Now, many of you know that this device has been the source of our Cronon research since 2010. But what only a select few of you know is that this device is at the center of Monarch's plans to navigate through the dangers of the future. This device...
Everybody get down!
Jesus, what the hell's that about? Hey, Beth, I'm headed down into the labs.
Okay. Bit of confusion here at the party. Serene's right-hand man's on stage. It was supposed to be Serene.
Yeah, I think Paul was too busy trying to have a heart-to-heart. Dr. Hammerall's office. Looks like that's one level up.
Thank you.
The device drained my powers.
We refer to it as a chronon dampener.
Are you sure this can't be traced back to us?
Impossible. I've adjusted the flight controls, so the drone will crash into the villa on your order.
Good. Very good. I'll make sure that Sophia's in position when the time is right. Wait for my call.
Getting more frequent. Okay, I gotta get to Dr. Amaral's office. When Paul visited me in that cell, he said time was a closed loop. Believed the fracture couldn't be fixed. Seeing the scale of that facility, it made me wonder. Time was ending? What was it all for?
Dr. Amaral's office. Looks like that's one level up.
The chart showed that all of Monarch's major technological advancements started in 2010. Around the same time that something else happened.
Ground zero.
Which way is Amron's office?
It was clear that Monarch had been building the Chronon technology for years. They were prepared for the fracture.
None of it would have been possible without the CFR.
Oh, hello. Might be able to get out from here. Dr. Amaral's office must be close. No alarms. Looks like nobody here knows about the mess I made on the way in. Nice job, Beth. That's Emerald's office. That there looks like what Beth wanted. Oh, shit. Emerald's at the party. The stutter won't last. I better find a way out of here and get to the party.
Amaral had tried to warn Paul. The end of time was approaching quickly. Less than 24 hours away.
Mr. Serene believed it would take years to run its course. Admittedly, he was wrong. Quite expensive piece of tech you stole.
Bill me. I knew Beth's cover wouldn't last long. Had to get it to her at the party before it was too late. What have we got here? Guns made to operate in a stutter. Paul had clear priorities. When time ends, guns don't. The Monarch combat gear was unwieldy. What I'd taken from Dr. Amaral's office was much lighter, almost like a civilian model. Sounds like the way out of this place. I'll get through the garage. Seems simple enough.
Easier. There's got to be a way out of here.
Adventures in Flesh by L. Hakola.
Chapter 11. Is somebody playing an audiobook over the radio?
Whoever that is, shut it off now.
Damn. think I'll just leave that room to lock everything down.
Somebody find out where that's coming from. This is supposed to be a secure channel.
Oh, shit. Okay. God, that's what I'm talking about. Beth, I got that device for you, but Dr. Amaral's at the party.
Yeah, I just spotted her. Wanna be my date?
Yeah, save me that cocktail weenie. I'll make my way there.
They say Hatch getting shot at was an insider job. They create a window for us, but Serena's looking for us. Remember what we said? That's the last of them.
It's Teresa here again.
I need the exact coordinates for Joyce ASAP. Monarch Actual is moving in to intercept.
This is Home Guard 5. Just spotted him entering the tunnel system outside the front grounds.
Beth?
I'm on my way.
He took out my entire squad.
Huh. Again.
I could see the mansion where the gala was. I had to find a way to get there. I could see the energy field of another Monarch Chronon dampener. It would drain my powers. I'd have to find a way to shut it off.
My powers won't work within that sphere. I better be careful.
We're headed for the party. What was your plan?
I needed to get to Dr. Amaral before the stutter ended and Monarch found out I was coming.
There's gotta be a way to get past that gate. Beth should be here somewhere. Need to get to her before the stutter ends.
A traitor fired shots during Mr. Hatch's speech. I assume this was Beth Wilder.
We both know it wasn't. Hatch wanted to send Monarch into a state of disarray.
Sir, just...
Best way to avoid blame?
I know he explained this
like the target.
Let me just confirm. Mr. Hatch really wants me to shoot him.
He wants you to shoot at him. and he wants it to be convincing. Your exit is as we've discussed. Get to your position, blend in. They'll think you're responding to what just went down. The blind spot you'll need has been prearranged.
I know the plan. I just don't get it.
You don't have to get it. You just have to do it and keep your mouth shut. This is way above your pay grade, son.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
He
arranged his own assassination? What the fuck? No idea I'd be shooting at half a puzzle amusement park.
Yeah, well, Monarch does. I don't think my cover's gonna last.
Yeah, well, I don't think it would do much good for the next part anyway.
Okay, Dr. Amaral's somewhere inside the mansion. Let's go grab her. Bit of luck, we can be gone before anybody notices.
Okay, lead the way. What's our plan once we grab her?
There's a boat dock right outside the mansion.
Okay, we can make that work.
shit! Oh, that drone!
It's in the wrong place at the wrong time. Literally.
Jack, Dr. Amaral's in there. We need to get her out before time kicks back. We shouldn't wait. Let's go get Dr. Amaral. Before time kicks back in and that drone turns us into paste.
Let's get to it, Doctor. Where's the damn boat?
It's right there.
Okay, go! Get her on the boat, I'll keep you.
Come on, go!
Go, hurry up!
I'll never get away with this.
Shit.
Get in!
It's Joyce! Somehow he got right past us! Don't let him escape! Somebody call Mrs. Green!
Jack, they're closing the gate. We'll be sitting ducks here unless you get it open for us.
I'll take care of it. You get going the second you can, okay?
Getting close.
Open it.
What about you?
You're clear. Go.
I can swing by and...
No. Just go. We went to all this trouble to grab her. Beth, I'm counting on you to keep her alive. Make my own way out.
My plan was simple. There's a bridge to the mainland. I'd fight my way through anything Monarch would throw at me and then steal a car. Drive it back to the swimming pool.
Just remember, we need your ass alive for the next part.
We'll see how it shakes out.
Thank you.
Beth and Dr. M are all clear, it was time for me to get gone. For that, I need wheels.
Okay, time to get a ride out.
Valet parking.
This thing growing inside me. I've been fighting it for 6 hard years. Dr. Amaral was developing a cure for the chronome. She was the only one who could administer the treatments that kept my sickness at bay.
Paul?
And Jack had taken her away from me.
Morton, how is it possible they managed to take her?
Paul, this is your illness talking. I'm on your side. Easy, you're...
They took her. Without Sophia, there's no chance of a cure.
We did all we could. But there are forces within Monarch working against you, and I believe Burke was just the tip of the iceberg. It wasn't just Joyce that did this.
Sir, we've recovered Dr. Amaral's laptop. We have it set up over there if you want to take a look.
I'll be right there. I want to go over Sophia's figures. If she's right, the fracture is escalating a lot faster than we anticipated.
You know the future. Dr. Amaral doesn't. Is the lifeboat viable state for activation? She's trying to convince you the schedule's wrong. Why? To get you to rush this? To make a mistake? The people opposing you. You're one of them.
She is.
Are you willing to bet the admit? I implore you, hold off on activation, Paul. Let me clean house before this gets completely out of hand. How do you want to be?
Somebody was working against me. Somebody close. Martin Hatch. Sophia Amaral. I could only trust one of them.
All right, Amaral. Let's go fix the time machine.
I said I'll try.
Evidence was mounting against Sophia. I couldn't simply ignore it, despite everything we had been through.
She knew you'd never make it without those treatments. And then she took them away.
If she'd turned against me, with me knew, the damage could be immeasurable.
I want him apprehended. Immediately.
Sir, I have some information about Martin Hatch.
Martin had been my closest advisor for years. I began to wonder if that had been a mistake.
Sophia's loyal. She's always been loyal.
I don't think we can trust her. The way she looked at the countermeasure like she's seen it before. She knows what it does.
Sophia's research had saved my life. Loyalty doesn't run any deeper.
Sophia's good. I'll trust her judgment. We need to analyze these figures and make final preparations to activate the lifeboat protocol at once.
Fine. I'll take the laptop to the science department.
No, I think I'll do that myself.
I see.
Sir?
Put people on Mr. Hatch. I want constant eyes on him.
Yes, sir. You got it. We pulled some images from the security cameras. We've identified Joyce's accomplice. She's Beth Wilder, one of our mid-level operatives.
Her. My God, she's been with us all along. She's working with Jack. Where is she now?
Unknown. But we've got a kill team tracking her.
No. She can't be killed. Not yet. Find her. And whatever Mr. Hatch does, I want to know about it. Don't screw this up. Beth Wilder. It was the first I heard her name. But she had been there in the past. When it all started. She'd been here the whole time, working against me from the inside. And she wasn't the only one.